Hi, it's Sophia, and happy Halloween! If you happen to be watching this video at a later time, welcome to Halloween 2020. We're in the middle of a raging pandemic, human rights are still being debated, and there's a chaotic presidential election going on in the US. So we have plenty of scary things going on at the moment, but hey, what's a few more, right? No, but in all seriousness, Halloween is one of my favorite holidays. I've always loved to dress up in different costumes and do different types of Halloween-y makeup looks. I went especially hard last year when I made a Joker costume from clothes that I found at a thrift store, completed the look with full-on face paint and green hairspray, and ended up winning a costume contest at a local bar. So suffice to say that I was pretty pleased with that outfit. But this video is something that I've been thinking about doing for well over a year now. But anyway, you probably read the title and saw the thumbnail, so in this video I am going to be making a Handmaid's Tale costume. Now, a few clarifications before we even get started. This video is not going to be a full-on sewing tutorial, nor really a review about the book or the series. This is just going to be me talking about my thoughts regarding the story and its cultural impact and Halloween costumes in general and other current themes that relate to this topic, and simultaneously chronicle the making of this costume. And I feel like this is a good spot for a trigger warning, because I will be talking about The Handmaid's Tale in this video. The subject matter is going to be quite heavy. Also, another heads up, there may be some spoilers about the book or the series in this video, although I'm not really gonna go through the plots too closely. But anyway, moving on. First of all, I thought I'd give you a brief summary of the story in Handmaid's Tale. Handmaid's Tale is a dystopian novel written by Margaret Atwood in 1985, and the most notable adaptation is the TV series that premiered on in 2017. The story takes place in the Republic of Gilead, a patriarchal totalitarian theocracy that was formed after the US government was overthrown in a revolution. Due to increased rates of infertility, the women who were still able to bear children are assigned to high-up officials to produce offspring. Now, this practice is based on the story of Rachel and Jacob in the Bible, where, in her desperation for not bearing children to her husband, Rachel offers him to go in onto her maid, Bilhah. The fertile women are therefore called handmaids and seen as nothing more than baby birthing vessels and property of their commanders. Now, the costumes play a big part in the story and act as a clear visual distinction for the status of the person. The handmaids wear red costumes to symbolize blood and their role as a childbearer. This color also makes the handmaids very easy to recognize in a crowd of people, which in turn makes it more difficult for them to escape. They also have white bonnets with a brim that covers the sides of their faces, essentially preventing them from seeing and being seen. The costume designer Anne Crabtree deserves all the rounds of applause for designing the clothes and the costumes in this show, and paying meticulous attention to the details that help in the world building of this story. For example, the women's costumes don't have any visible zippers or buttons, because that would insinuate the possibility of taking the clothes off, and that is far too seductive for a pious society like the one in Gilead. I would highly recommend watching some videos where she goes further into the design choices behind the costumes. Obviously, the costumes on the show are a bit more complex and have better design than whatever I'm gonna be able to do, but I'm gonna do the best with what I've got. Now, I bought this, and I think it's like an old bedsheet maybe, from a charity shop for 2 euros, and I'm going to use this fabric to make the dress. For the bonnet, I got this white fabric, which I think is like a kid's bedsheet or something, from the same charity shop for, again, 2 euros, I think. And most importantly, I got these plastic placemats from the same charity shop for 50 cents each. Now they're completely white on one side and then they have this weird brown pattern on the other side. But I figured if I were to just cover, I think I'm only gonna need one, but if I were to just cover this with the white fabric, I think we should be able to like make the wings using this placemat. For the dress, the main reference I used is this picture of Moira's costume. So I'm thinking of doing like a 3/4 sleeve top with a fabric belt across the waist and a zipper closure at the back. I'm gonna use some old patterns that I've used to make a shirt dress and just modify them if need be. I'm going to also try to make the dress about ankle length, but I'll have to see how much fabric I have left after finishing the top part. And for the bonnet, I'm going to follow some YouTube videos and just try to figure out how to make it work. So with all that being said, I think I can just get to the sewing.
I've been a fan of The Handmaid's Tale ever since the series was released on Hulu, and in fact, I would go as far as to say that it is my favorite TV show ever. This summer, I also finally managed to read the original book that the series is based on, which had been on my to-do list for a couple of years now. Watching the series was the first time that a TV show made me feel such intense emotions of fear, anxiety, disgust, injustice, and frustration. I find it also serves as a reminder of all the liberties that I currently have regarding education, relationships, and just ownership of my own body, and that this has not always been, and in some cases, is still not the reality for some women. What I find the scariest about the show and the book is that none of the brutal, horrible things that happen are actually even fiction. They're all things that have happened in some point in history, or even worse, there are things that are still happening. Topics like FGM, discrimination based on gender and sexuality, and the denial of reproductive rights are all issues we still have to face to this day. Combined with the current tumultuous political atmosphere, it would be foolish to take the things that I have for granted. This show gives me this sense of urgency, that we must still fight to hold on to the liberties and values that are important to us, and that allow us to live our lives in a way that makes us happy. As they say, don't let the bastards grind you down. So, with a costume as meaningful as this, it's no wonder that it has been worn in protests. Most recently at the confirmation hearing for Supreme Court Justice candidate Amy Coney Barrett. The costume is a silent visual act of resistance and a way to object the legislative decisions being made that could impact our rights. Although it might seem like we're light years away from a dystopian Gilead, we can't simply rely on the fact that things aren't just that terrible yet. The series should remind all of us that a descent into a totalitarian society doesn't necessarily happen all of a sudden, but rather by small, incremental changes. As it is said in the book, nothing changes instantly. In a gradually heating bathtub, you'd be boiled to death before you knew it. Seeing how impactful and distinct the Handmaid's costume is, it shouldn't come as a surprise that many retailers are selling their versions of the red dress and white bonnet. However, in 2018 there was a certain incident where an online store called Yandy decided to manufacture and sell this brave red maiden costume. Right off the bat, that's quite eye-roll worthy, but for the company, it was business as usual, especially since they basically specialize in turning popular themes into sexy Halloween costumes. And I mean, in all honesty, some of their costumes are fun and flirty, but some, including this Red Maiden costume, are just questionable at best. For example, they have a habit of turning cultures into stereotypical costumes. Back in 2016, they used to sell costumes inspired by Native Americans, and they still sell Eskimo and Dia de los Muertos costumes. Also, I just found it kind of weird that they sell so many sexy ninja costumes. But I do want to say that I don't have anything against sexy Halloween costumes in general. To quote Mean Girls, Halloween is the one day a year when a girl can dress up like a total slut and no other girls can say anything else about it. Come to think of it, that kind of highlights the problematic attitudes society has against female sexuality. Like, why do we need an excuse if we want to be sexy? But alas, that's a whole other video. What I'm trying to say is that I do see the empowerment aspects and the general excitement to look cute and dress up for Halloween parties. And there are a plethora of costumes that you can make sexy, and there shouldn't be any problem with that. And if there is, that is simply policing women's bodies and that's called sexism, but again, whole other video. The thing here is that some costumes have context behind them, like culture or tradition, for example. And that context is what makes the costume insensitive. When it comes to the Handmaid's costume, the context is a story about a world where women are being exploited and abused. Wearing a sexy version of a costume that ultimately represents the denial of basic human rights does kind of seem out of touch, which was evident in the responses that people posted on Twitter regarding the sexy Handmaid's costume. Now, you might completely disagree with me, and at the end of the day, it is just a silly costume you wear one time in a year. I mean, even Margaret Atwood herself took the sexy maiden costume very lightheartedly. But like I've already said, even though the book and the show might be a work of fiction, the topics that the show deals with are very real. So making and selling a sexy version of that costume just feels like a mockery towards the people who experience that type of oppression. After facing backlash on the internet, the retailer did end up pulling the costume from their store and releasing a public apology. So, I guess that's the end of the Brave Red Maiden, but a questionable Halloween costume isn't the only incident that has stirred up some controversy. In June 2019, Kylie Jenner hosted a Handmaid's Tale viewing party and posted pictures on social media of herself and her guests wearing Handmaid's costumes. People were quick to call this out as off-putting and tone-deaf. Although I'm personally happy that Kylie seems to be a fan of the show, I too wonder if the message of the series went a bit over her head. It is also quite possible that from a privileged position, detached from certain everyday struggles that come along with less privilege, it might be easier to view the show as simple entertainment. Or maybe all she tried to do was express her appreciation towards the show and figured that it was also a good chance to have a costume party with her friends. And seeing that I'm making a whole video about making a Handmaid's dress, I can't really fault her for that. Because if I'm being completely honest, I do feel like I'm treading a fine line by making this dress and bonnet, and calling it a Halloween costume. The last thing I want to do is come off as insensitive, especially since this story means so much to me. That being said, I do feel like Halloween offers a good opportunity to dress up as a handmaid. After all, Halloween is a time for scary things, and frankly, this costume represents my worst fears. In creating this costume, I wanted to remain respectful towards the context of the story, which is why I did my best at following actual reference pictures from the show. Making the costume sexier definitely wasn't on my agenda. As I was making this costume, I realized how oddly disturbing some of the details were. Covering the zipper pull with a separate fabric flap so that it wouldn't be out in the open, far too incisingly. The white wings that truly do obstruct your vision, making you feel more isolated from your surroundings. The wide, structured waistband that almost feels like armor or a chastity belt. These are things I never really considered while I was watching the show, but coming face to face with them in the making process of this costume was quite eye-opening. What really strikes me about the costumes in the show is how current and even fashionable they look. The show's costume designer, Anne Crabtree, mentioned in one video that I watched that her goal was not to make historical period drama type costumes, but costumes that look like they could belong in the present. Even though the styles are influenced by the modest fashions of previous decades or centuries even, the silhouettes of the costumes have this timeless feel to them, which in turn makes the show look like it could easily take place in the near future. The dress I made in this video did turn out to be a bit more conservative, because the fabric I used is stiffer and not as flowy, and I made the skirt full length, but even my dress has a contemporary silhouette on the upper body, since I adapted this dress from a modern shirt dress pattern. And although my winged bonnet did turn out to be a bit smaller than the ones used on the show, I feel like the general shape is very close to accurate. All in all, I'm quite pleased with this project, especially considering that I made this costume entirely from secondhand materials. This took me many, many hours and a lot more hand-stitching than I had originally thought, but it was a lot of fun. And with that, it's done.
I can't believe that this costume is actually finally done. It was definitely not the easiest journey, and I especially struggled making this bonnet, but I learned a lot along the way and I'm actually really happy with how this costume turned out. Although I must admit that now that I'm finally wearing the whole ensemble, I have this general feeling of unease. The dress fits me just fine, and even the bonnet is quite comfortable to wear, but I think it's just the emotional baggage that comes with a costume like this. It's like I'm actually putting myself in the situation of a handmaid, and that's quite uncomfortable, to be honest. You know what? Maybe I'll just take the wings off at this point. Whew, that actually feels a lot better. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed watching this video, seeing the process of making this costume, and listening to my ramblings about all sorts of stuff. Feel free to leave any and all comments down below. I'd love to hear your opinions about Handmaid's Tale, Halloween costumes, and all that. Leave a like if you enjoyed watching this video, and subscribe if you want to see more content like this. You can also follow me on Instagram at Sofia Mainen. But until next time, under his eye.